bless your holy name this morning.
Hallelujah.
We give you all the glory. We give you all the honor.
Hallelujah.
We thank you for all what you have done and what you are doing in our life.
Thank you,
we thank you for the families.
Thank you
for the love of Christ.
Thank you
for the salvations of our souls.
Thank you
for the joys of our children.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you for half of the year grace that we are still moving on and moving strong. We thank you for all the investment of men and that of God in our life. Thank you for the joy that we have shared in the birth, the resurrection, and even the glory of Jesus. Be thou exalted this morning in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, we are here to study again. We consider this season, this time, as the time of our own upper room. Lord, we pray, as we go through this another act this morning, let your presence, O Lord, draw your power to us in thy name, O Jesus Christ. Let the empowerment of the Holy Spirit, O Lord, sit upon every individual soul this morning.
Amen.
In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Thank you, everlasting Father.
Thank you, Lord.
In Jesus' mighty name we are praying.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Good morning.
Good morning, sir.
Please have your seats. God bless you. One thing I wanted to let everybody know is there are two types of gains in life. There is one gain that that hurts you. There's another one that changes you. The two needs to come. It is you that will now turn the pain to anyone that you wanted to. Once again, you can see the leadership and the kind of the church empowerment that Pastor Glory gave this morning. You need to be prepared. You are children of the Most High. Forget about by the birth by which you have given birth to. You should be able to stand and stand tall with God.
Yes.
You should be able to make sure that whatever you are doing and anything that is happening to you, that God is being glorified in everything in it.
Yes,
and I pray this morning, anywhere you stand, God will stand with you.
Amen.
In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Quickly open your Bible with me to... First of all, welcome to our worker empowerment section. And thank God for the grace of leadership. It's not my permit. So under the authority of another person leading this, I'm standing this morning. And that's the person of Pastor Glory. Thank you very much. And I pray that the little I'm going to share today, all of us be blessed, and
Amen.
All our internet viewers too be blessed in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Open your Bible with me to Genesis 3. Genesis 3, 16. Genesis chapter 3, verse 16. The Bible says, to the woman he said, I will greatly multiply your pain in childbirth. In pain, you will bring four children. Yet, your desire will be for your husband, and he will rule over you. Like we were taught in the Bible college, that to every word spoken by God, there is always another word that will back it up. So the backup text for today's teaching can be found in Esther 1, Book of Esther, chapter 1, verses 10 to 11. Esther chapter 1, verses 10 to 11. The Bible says, on the seventh day, when the heart of the king was merry with wine, he commanded Mehuman, Bigta, Hapuma, Bigta, Abata, Septa, and Kakas, the seven eunuchs who serve in the presence of King Ahasuerus, to bring Queen Vashti before the king with her royal crown in order to display her beauty to the people and the princes, for she was beautiful. This morning, I've been asked to speak on a title team as what husband requires from their wives. What husband requires from their wives. I'm just 19 years old this year as a married man.
Woo!
I was still 20 years old in a relationship. So whatever I'm going to be sharing today will be based on my experience, on what I witnessed in my father's as an husband, and the grace I've received in the past 20 years of relationship, and that of 19 years of marriage, and also 18 years of being a father. Now, the thing I will start with is we need to introduce what the meaning of the husband. Because I've been asked to talk about the husband requirement from their wife. And another thing I wanted to, I've put myself under the allegiance of the obedience of God, that I will be plain and I will be real. That was the one of the conditions that was attached to this title, to this teaching. Who is the husband? Who is the person called the husband? And let me say at this point, for the people who are going through relationship crisis, people who have been hurted, people who think that, look, I don't think that this thing works. It works. Before you can be, or you can have the title husband, it is after you have married that particular sweetheart of yours, that your girlfriend. It is after the wedding, the relationship has been being together and end in marriage. On the day you married that particular woman, that is when you had that title of being a husband. Being an husband does not say that you have to have, it is a thing that is a must that you have to have, to have children. The title of husband is your commitment to the vow, the promises, those things through which you attracted the woman to yourself. Because one thing, before the woman will say, I do or I agree, there is always a proposal. The condition is not limited to beauty, to handsomeness, to sin or not sin. I've seen blind man who end up becoming a good husband, who end up even entering into a husband. I've seen a layman. I've seen people that became husband even in the terminal point of their death. They had that title because the proposal was made and the lady looked at it. Okay, I cannot wait for the rest of my life. That is it. The other aspect why that will make husband to expire, for that title to be expired, is when the proposal, those promises are not being kept, or those promises are no more real, then there is something then that the darkness world that separates things that revalidate the promises, the proposals, and that is what the woman being called divorce. The moment divorce comes in, you go back to that title of being a single man. You are no more an husband. An husband is a title that comes with responsibility to keep the promises, the proposals given to the end of that relationship. Let's see what Bible define or express in the term husband. Genesis 1:26.
Then God said, let us make human beings in our image to be like us. They will reign over the fish of the sea, the birds of the sky, the livestock, all the wild animals on the earth, and the small animals that scurry along the ground.
Praise the Lord. That is That is a reading that we just want to talk. I'm here to impact. So please, because this is where my major discussion will be established. Genesis 1:26, Bible says, then God said, that is God now, let us make man in our image. That is something that's coming up now. According to our likeness, and let them rule over the fish of the sea, and over the birds of the sky, and over the cattle, and over all the herd, and over every creeping thing that creeps on the earth. From this verse, who can actually tell me where an husband is defined by God? Yes, ma'am.
Let us make man in our image, according to our likeness. Let them rule over the fish of the sea.
Okay. So where is the, which one is the definition of husband now?
Is a ruler.
To have our likeness.
The definition of an husband or a husband in this text
is your responsibility.
You are giving me function. As husband is being defined through this text, yes?
Is defined as the image of God.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. That's one, yes. There are so many definitions here. Yes, sir.
According to our likeness.
According to our likeness. So that means an husband is like God.
Yes.
He's a God.
Yes.
Two, he has the image, an husband should look like God. Yes? Anybody?
He has the authority.
An husband,
all the earth.
An husband is somebody that
is actually in charge.
The custodian of the relationship. A ruler. But not a dictator. God, now let me just, because of my time. God himself said, Genesis 1:26, Bible says, then God said, let us make man. So, first of all, in my definition, the husband must be a man. He's a male person in a marital relationship. An husband cannot be a female. An husband cannot be a dog. An husband cannot be your likeness or your emotion that you want to. I just love my jewelry, and I'm going to. When I was growing up, I think I should be my university days. Should it be? Oh no, I think I started working, and I didn't know that it was true or not. I didn't know. I think my son too shared with me when we got to this country that a musician puts a kind of a good band around his waist, and they say it's pure gold, and the value was so expensive that he has to even insure it for a very big lot of money. I was looking at it. Is she married to the chain around her waist, or is that the value of the person that's going to be her husband? Now, husband must be a male person. He said, let us make man. A person that looks like God in our image. A mother created from God. Let us make. He must be formed by God. All the things that he is going to be doing and must be doing must be according to the word of God. According to the phrase by which God has formed it. When we have remote control is to do something for us that we needed to do or we must do physically. And then we want to do it without even having a contact. Your hand is to help you in feeding, in defending, in carrying, in supporting you. Your hand is not where you take your water and drink it. It's you drink through your mouth. It must be a mortar created from dust. It must be the first person in the marriage. According to our likeness. 1 Timothy 2:13. 1 Timothy 2:13 says, "For Adam was formed first, and then Eve." That has been established. Now, let's continue. Once again, the title I was given was "What Husband Requires from Their Wives." Please, let's do this thing together. It should be interactive. What husband requires from
the wives?
The only thing that joins this thing together, two people are always in marriage. The husband and the wife. Now, what we wanted to look at this morning, the focal point this morning, is the requirement of the man from the wife. What every man called husband are looking for. So I am using my of experience of 20 years in relationship, and that of my father that through which I was grew up. A few people that I grew up with, people like my mentor that actually gave me the platform for me to appreciate love, Mr. Ademola Jala. I stayed with him in Warri. And I used to tell my wife, I said, "This is a man that make me to see dignity in beauty than beauty in love." He used all his life to make sure that his house was established and stay established. He has 5 children by the grace of God. 3 of them are medical doctors. The first child, Bomi, had a PhD at the age of 23. Doing fine. My little friend and my little brother, she is doing well. The only son. These are the people that I spent the quality of my life for me to be able to appreciate what love is. And it was that love that made me to become who I am today. The requirements of the husband from the wife. One, things that I'm not going to be talking this morning is that I'm not going to be talking about expectation of husband from wife. No. It's not what anybody can expect. In fact, there are so many expectations that we are expecting, looking for. I'm not going to talk about the demand of husband from their wife. I'm not going to. There are some things that every husband wanted their wives to do for them. Give me. They want to do. I'm not going to talk about things or those things that husbands need to enforce from their wives. I'm not going to talk about the compelling husband that is looking for, look. Ah, no. I must compel you. You must put a veil. You must walk this way. I'm not talking about that. Out of this thing I said I'm not going to talk about, I have myself too. I have some things that I needed to learn out of this thing I'm not going to talk about. But this morning I'm going to be talking about or teaching or encouraging us on the requirements of the husband from their wives. This is a kind of the things that make relationship to flourish. The first thing is authority or control. Every husband requires authority and control from their wives. Before a man will propose a marriage unto a woman, that man must be able to know that, look, this woman, if I've seen that she has accepted me to be the head and to be the cover. Let them call themselves names. Let them even become, let even that girl be the best in the class or in the educational or anywhere they work. That man must have seen the agent, the title, the element of authority from that woman. That woman, there are so many things. Let me use my wife. Before I proposed, the first thing I got from my wife was that she decided to bring me into the entire family of ours. She allowed our junior sisters to pass through me for anything they needed from her. She gave me that right that people call privilege to administer into her finances and then the rest of her days. So when I saw that, I said, okay, no problem. Irrespective of where she came from, I think we have something to work about here. So the first thing, like I said, is what?
Authority.
Or
control.
That particular lady must have the ingredient that, look, I'm under your control. Do I have Bible passage for that? Let's see what God said in Genesis 1:26. The Bible says, then God said, let us make man in our image, according to our likeness, and let them do what?
Rule.
Over what?
Fish.
That's the first thing. The first thing that God commanded man to rule. How come that God did not say that we should rule over the heart? These are the things that I examined this morning. I look at this verse and I say, Lord, I want you to please speak through this particular verse so that I will be able to tell the people what all husbands are looking for in the standard of God. Let me tell you something. How come that the first thing that happened in friendship to relationship is the change of name? Nobody is going to teach you. Your mom is not going to tell you that, call that man, sweetheart, call that. In fact, one of the words that actually won my wife to me was that when I was in worry and we need to start exchanging discussion or words, when I called her, and even in the morning, we may have privilege to talk again in the night, Amy, before closing time. But that time, telephone is very, very expensive. I will call. I say, you know what, babe? I love you. Please, I have a sweet dream. Oh my friend, they'll be laughing. Hey, somebody that is at work, you are asking her to dream. I say, have a sweet dream. Good night. Sweet words. Then later, these boys to men, I mean, or men to boy. Which was their name?
Boys to Men.
Boys to Men came out. And they sang that song, Mama. When I look at it, I say, Mama. This girl might be thinking that I'm equating her to my mom. Mom, in the first instance, I don't call my mom, Mama. I call my own in the Ibadan word. The same word of Mama, but not Mama. It's Mommy. That is local one, and it's not common to a lot of people. So it's like all other languages. Now I said, okay, I'm going to call something out. Then I think I begin to call her something like Mama too, but I can't remember it now. So I begin to. Because I call now from that boss to men, Mama. So that's like I can't fall for God's track. And so and my wife loved it. And then before, the first person that confirmed that was my immediate boss, Mr. Digo. He just came to worry. I was in a project between worry and suffering. He just said, when was the last time you spoke to Mama? Because we are always in hotel together. And first thing the morning I will do, I will talk to her in Lagos. While in the car, maybe I'm on my way from hotel to the project site. My wife will be from Lagos to Lagos Island. And so she also called. When was the last time you talked to Mama? I said, this thing is working. So when I got back to his own house in Lagos, I saw that man too was calling his wife, Mama, almost 68 years old. I said, this thing works. So I designed a card. I still have the card in my wallet this morning. Carry that. I still have it. Maybe you want to see that. I still have it. So, and the first thing God said, rule over the fish. Why fish? Fish are actually something precious. You don't see them anyhow. Even when you see them, you need to soil your heart. You need to wet your hand. You need to leave. You your comfort zone. You need to fish for them. You need to look for sensitive equipment. You need to set a bait and an attraction. These are animals that are not in the same living spheres of where you grew up with, of your thinking. But one thing is this, these are animals that you must see. And then when you bring them out, they always look fresh. Ephesians 5, 23, 22, 23. Ephesians 5, 22, 23. The Bible says, wives, submit yourself to your own husband as you do to the Lord. For the husband is the head of the wife, as the Christ is the head of the church, his body and of which is Savior. Let me tell you, why is it that look at how many, the younger teenager in this church, the first thing they will always wrestle with is that I don't want an husband is going to be who's going to tell me or boss over me. But then they agree that they are the one, or I mean as a female, they are the one that was okay, I do. It is for the man to say, will you? And to propose. But one thing is that how come that they are always, I don't want a man that is always authoritative, that's always do this. But one thing is that if you need to submit your authority, and you know that this is the king, the thing that started a marriage, how come now that people work against it? I want to let you know that anything good, the imitation always looks the same, but the only thing it does not last. Bible says that, wife, submit yourself. God himself now said in verse 23, said the husband is the head of the wife. You know, when anytime a wife, I don't know, anytime, very, 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 very rare, and he said, you know what, I'm not in contention of your position in this house. I will now say, what are we discussing to that level? It's not debatable. It's not debatable. It's not debatable. No, what are we discussing? Sometimes I will not ask that. I said, look, excuse me, where did you hear this kind of words? It's not debatable. The Lord help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
How do we settle this? How do we expect women or wives to settle this aspect of authority and control? We expect them to respect us. We expect all the wives to treat us like kings. Look at what we read in that the book of Esther. The king wanted the queen to come and present herself first of all to the people, his guests, and even our own children, the princes, and even the entire people. The Bible now said, for the king knows that Vashti was beautiful. Treat your husband like kings. Every the first instruction that a good mother would tell their daughter is, make sure that your husband comes first. But did they carry that along? It's not. My father told me, he said, everything your mommy has done to me, your wife is going to do the same. It's not a curse. Because one thing is that they are coming until when their children become their husband. That is when they are going to be correcting most of these mistakes. The third thing is that pleasant treatment in words and in voice. How come that when you are cutting, you have the argument, even when you argue with love? I remember the first time I entered into Mr. Beach, my wife, and I entered this, I ordered for this fiesta, his potatoes matched with egg and fried egg. And I was enjoying it. And while they were serving, before I paid, I just carried one like this with my hand and by the man. I just begin to, my wife just came and said, please now. And she was just correcting me. But it's not like that anymore. It's not. If I can mess up in the public, and you came very close, even the attendant could not even see. The attendant was saying, oh, you mean your husband loves our this thing? She said, yeah. But can you imagine? I carry a pillow. I use one to be working on my computer, on my laptop, and I use another one to rest. And my wife is coming. I mean, I was the first person in bed. I said, don't you know that you're supposed to have only one pillow? The same, look at the one in the public and the one in our bedroom. And I said, okay, is it not the same girl that collected me?
You've been taught now.
Thank you.
Now, the next thing is that we want them to be self-dependent, but not self-dependent themselves. We want you or the wife to share their hearts, their feelings, including their emotions. Time will not permit me, because I have a lot of things. I don't know whether they are going to give me some time or if not, I'm stopping here. But one thing is this, what do you think? Why do you think that even quality men look up on girl with skipping skirt? Pastor do. Pope do. How? No. I will tell you this. How come that the mothers are not dressing like all these people that will just dress everything? You will see the best sisters in the entourage of the Pope. You will see them with very iron, good contoured skirt, designer, with good shoes. You will still see their tight on. They will still be doing like a pigeon when they already promised their allegiance to the Lord in form of their mind and their emotion. They will still be there. They will still. How come in the airline that the best, even the ugliest, waitresses, when you set your eyes, in fact, if you are not standing very well, how come that they will come to you? Say, excuse me, sir, do you want a cup of water? You will not say no. You say, yes. Thank you very much. Why? Because of what? They are sharing their feelings open. Time will not permit me. I have the second thing as exceptional beauty and classical. And then the third thing I have here is the aspect of total support. And lastly, that I put here is the South 824. Don't think sex is because of marriage. Husband are not looking for sex. That's not the ultimate. When I look at the story of two people this morning in this aspect of sex, this is not about the sex, it's the desire of it. The desire of the sex in art, in performance, in giving and in demanding. Look at Tamar to Judah. Genesis 38:24. Bible says, he said now, it was about 3 months later that Judah was informed. This is just, I'm not pouring myself in this. Your daughter-in-law, Tamar, has played the harlots. How come that your own daughter-in-law cannot even spare your son on the girl you are sleeping with? Harlots come to do those things that men are looking for in their wives. You are paying an harlot. Harlot is telling you, how do you want it? Harlot will tell you, it will take you to where she or she has prepared. Nobody carry harlot to their house except the useless men who has lost the title of husband and now they're single. You carry them to the best hotel. Even the brothel, they make it prepare and have the bed. I've not priced anyone, so I don't know how it works. But from experience and from the experience of people who shared and from the film available. So don't cast me this morning. But one thing I'm telling you, ask any man. You will not see any alert. Smell it. But you know. The Lord help us. I rest my case this morning. Submission of God. That I want to let you know that what men are actually looking for in requirement for women are not things difficult. It's just a thing that the moment you, the fish is exceptional. The next thing is the rule over the bed. I want to let you know that you need to be classical. Beauty might be deception, but let me tell you, a woman that fears the Lord will never lose the crown of her head. The Lord bless us in Jesus' name. You have questions? I've not even finished, but no problem. So I submit here. So this is not all I have, but this is what the time can give me. God bless you. Well, I'm under authority. This is what I have. So no problem. God bless us. In Jesus' name. Yes.
Let's go back to that point that had the list.
The list of
things the first point you made, that list. Yes, that one. You said when you were discussing the last point, you said men expect women to be self-dependent, but not self-dependent to themselves.
To themselves, yes.
Can you, because self-dependence means you're dependent to yourself. So saying you don't expect them to be self-dependent to themselves is totally contradictory.
No, good. What I mean by this is this. No, it's okay. Now, is this. Let me tell you, when I was courting my husband, my wife, when we were in a relationship, I was earning a salary of 5,000 naira. My wife was earning a salary of about 75,000 thereabouts. Now, she's already a self-dependent. But one thing I told her is that, look, everything must be spent on the agreement of both of us. I won't do anything on this money without letting you know. It's your money. But the first thing I did was that all that 5,000 I'm adding, she's here this morning. What would I, after my salary, what did I normally do?
Put
in my purse. So that people can hear you.
Drop everything in my purse.
Once I collect my salary in Warri, I have people who are still living witness to it. I have a friend called Afolabi Nosi. He's still in Warri, doing oil and marketing. Now, I collect that money in the envelope, 5,000 naira. Most of the time, I always have my ticket back to Lagos. That is this Benin Edegbe songs and this thing. So once I get to Lagos, she picked me up from Ojota and then we go. She has a car, I don't have a car. The moment we are coming down, I will drop the wallet, the envelope, into her. She was the first person that started paying tithes on everything I had. I was born Christian, we are not taught on tithe as a Catholic. Mm-hmm. Nobody enforced it. My father didn't pay tithe. So that's I'm telling you now. So, but after that, she will say, okay, we need to go and visit your parents in Ibadan. And then maybe we give them 1,000 naira out of that. She give me 1,000 naira to my expenses for the month. And then for my friends who stay with me, 1,000 naira. And then she will use the 2,000 for herself. And then delete. Our own salary will be in the bank. I want to let you know that was the money that we settled with when we got married. We built this particular salary to the tune of almost 1.8 million naira in 1999. When dollars was just about 20 naira to a dollar. I mean 20 naira to a dollar. Because a friend of mine sent us money that time that we changed to Kayode Akintayo. She was self-dependent, but one thing is that we make sure that self-dependent in outside to make her to be whom she is was subjected to the agreement of the authority and the control of the husband. I didn't compel her. Yes, sir. Please, I think so that we got the battery. Can you? Okay.
Amen.
Amen.
Sunday school, please.